Thank you for the nice introduction. Thank you for the organizer for inviting me here. Really sorry that I couldn't be here since the start of the conference, but I enjoyed the part that I participated in. So today, I'm going to give you my idea of ethics in AI in general, and also in decision making, which is my research area. And so I will start by telling you what AI is for me, because I think that more and more, given this overhype of AI in the media and overall everywhere, it is not that clear, it's not that obvious that AI is what I think it is, you know. And I think that this view is consistent with the view also of the last invited speakers, that mostly AI is not just deep learning or is not just machine learning, but it has many, many different disciplines, because an AI system needs more reasoning capabilities than what can be currently provided, I think, by machine learning. So, of course, it needs to be aware of its environment, so it needs to see, it needs to hear, it needs to understand natural language, perceive the environment around it, and this definitely the deep learning, you know, techniques have helped a lot in recent years. It has to be able to model the world around the AI system, so knowledge representation. It has to be able to reason on top of that knowledge, so knowledge reasoning. Once it has these reasoning capabilities, it has to be able to understand what to do, so decisions about what to do in the real world. So you need decision making, planning, scheduling, and you need to be able to discriminate between good and bad decision. And this ties, of course, to the ethical capabilities of an AI system to discriminate between, for example, ethical or non-ethical decision. And it has to, of course, adapt to new situation, to tasks that are not very well specified, and through learning, of course. And it has to sometimes physically act in the real world, not just being software, so also robotics and so on. And as you know, of course, in recent years, this convergence of deep learning techniques, which are new, but not that new with respect to techniques that were like even in the 80s, I mean, they're new but innovative, but not that significantly new. But together with the huge amount of data that are available in the difference for the different tasks, and also the exponentially increasing computing power, then these three things together allow these techniques to really be more and more successful, because they could use this huge amount of data through the computing capabilities to really learn to do several tasks in a very accurate way, and so to address tasks that previously were not